It's been more than a year since Lyme scooters came to Norfolk, and now new data is out about how many miles that Norfolk riders have been racking up. 13 News Now reporter Madison Kimbrough spoke with Lyme and the city of Norfolk to get answers, as well as find out how often those scooters are cleaned.
The numbers are in, and during the first year of Lyme e-scooter operations in Norfolk, riders racked up nearly 600,000 miles. The city of Norfolk welcomed the Lyme scooters back in June of 2019. And since then, the city has accumulated over 1,000 scooters in the area.
They originally started off at 500, but we had performance metrics built in. So if they reached so many ride trips per scooter per day, they could request to increase their fleet. And I think they originally requested to go up to 700 and then 900, and then now they're at 1,100. And that seems to be a good number for Norfolk.
As for the cleanliness of the scooters, the level of vigilance is incredibly high now that we're in a pandemic.
The scooters are ridden throughout the day, and then every single night a scooter, when it gets down to a certain percentage of battery, is brought in. So that's brought in either by our warehouse staff or through our contract staff, and those vehicles are then cleaned, and then there is a full inspection of those vehicles.
Lyme disinfects all surfaces and allows for the surface to be visibly wet for 5 minutes while letting it air dry. The main focus is, of course, the most used areas like the handlebars, brakes, and throttle. And if you were wondering the best place to park your scooter, for now it's on the side of the sidewalk, leaving at least 3 feet of clearance for people to walk by. Inman says the city plans on installing designated areas to make it easier for people to drop off and access the Lyme scooters as well.
We are in the process of developing a scooter parking program for the downtown area. We will have dedicated parking for the scooters so that we can start to get them out of the sidewalk.
In Norfolk, Madison Kimbrough, 13 News Now.